So this video is going to give you some basic definitions and examples of tangent lines and circles. Now back in the introductory video to circles, we saw that a line that intersects a circle exactly once is called a tangent line, and that the intersection point is called a point of tangency. In this case, the beige line at the top of the screen, according to the orientation that we have right here, that intersects the circle at point T is a tangent line because it intersects the circle centered at A once and only once. Now there are some properties and theorems related to tangents, we're going to see them later, but when it comes to one circle and one tangent, that's about as interesting as it gets. But we can have lines that are tangent to multiple circles, and we can have multiple lines that are tangent to the same set of circles, and we call those common tangents. So go ahead, pause the video, copy down this definition for common tangent, as well as what you see here. Come back when you're ready to move on. So you notice an important difference between the two tangents that we have on the screen here. The beige tangent that's at the top of the screen, according to how we're looking at it, seems to go across the top of both circles and doesn't pass between them the same way that the yellow line does. Specifically, that yellow line crosses through a segment that connects the centers of these two circles. And because those two tangents are different in this important way, we have different names and terminology for those two tangents. The beige line, one that does not cross the segment connecting the centers of the circles, is called an external tangent, where the yellow line that does cross the segment connecting the centers of the circles, which is now on the screen in this very light blue, so be careful to observe that, is called an internal tangent. So go ahead, pause the video, copy down these two definitions, add the segment connecting the circles so that you can see the difference between the two types of tangents, and come back when you're ready to see one more set of definitions. So there is one more way that we can talk about tangency in circles. We've seen what happens when a circle is tangent to a line, and we've seen lines that are tangent to multiple circles. But circles can also be considered tangent to each other. And what tangent circles have in common is that they are tangent to the same line at the same point. And there are two different ways that this can happen. In one case, which you can see on the left, we have what we call externally tangent circles, which means that the center of one circle is not contained in the other, and they are both tangent to the same line, which is being drawn in black here, at the same point, which we can see right there, which we'll call point T. These are called externally tangent circles because the center of one circle is external to the other circle. On the right, we see an example of what we call internally tangent circles. That is, the center of one circle is actually contained within another circle, like circle C is contained within circle A. Again, they are both tangent to the same line, and tangent to the same line at the same point, but as you can see with that intersection there, they are now tangent to a point that is not contained on the segment that connects the two centers of the circles, and we'll call that tangency point P. So that is it for this video. I'm going to ask you to pause the video now. Just a few introductory definitions and explanations and diagrams for you. We'll dive more into tangents and circles as you continue working through this module. But go ahead, pause the video, copy down everything you see on the screen now, and then you'll be ready to move on.